Good morning class, welcome to full syllabus channel. Today we will be doing diborane and organoboranes as reducing agent. The synthesis of diborane is by sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride is reacted with boron trifluoride and it forms diborane in the process. It basically reduces alkene, alkyne, carbonyl group and it gives various reactions such as isomerization, carbonization, which I will be dealing today. Okay class, so let's do the first simple reaction with alkene. When alkene is treated with diborane, it gets attached to the alkene in a Markownikoff fashion. As you know, borane is more electropositive than hydrogen, hence as the rule says, the more electropositive group will be going to, or the more electronegative group will be going to, in a Markownikoff nature, will be going to the more substituted carbon. Hence, this will be getting the H and this will be getting the boron. Afterwards, with hydrolysis, oxidation hydrolysis, it will be converted to an alcohol. And if we take a aldehyde, it is also converted to alcohol. Okay class, let's do the mechanism of hydroboration. Once the alkene is taken, it reacts with BH3. So as I told you, the H will be attacking the carbon which is having more substitution, that is, which is having more R group as compared to less H. Right, so H will be going here, BH2 will be going here, and this kind of an intermediate will be formed. Afterwards, this kind of organoborane will be formed in the process. As you can see, boron has two more hydrogen left, so it can react with two more alkene. This is the intermediate that will be formed when the BH3 will be reacting with three alkenes. Now this will be oxidized with the help of H2O2 in the presence of NaOH to alcohol. So let's see the mechanism. H2O2 with OH negative will give us HOO negative, right, which will be the attacking species, which will be attacking boron. As you can see, boron is bonded to three carbons only. It can get one more bond which will be given by oxygen, hence this intermediate will be formed. But as you know, OO bond is a little weak in nature. This will be going, and in turn this carbon will be attacking here. So intramolecular shift will be seen in this kind of intermediate. After this shift occur, the boron is now again electron deficient and can be attacked by another molecule of OOH negative. So if it attack this molecule again, there will be an intramolecular shift and you will get a species where this R group will be attached to oxygen. In the third step also, again OH negative will be attacking, and the last final product you will be getting is this, which is afterwards hydrolyzed to get alcohol, and H3BO3 is produced as a product. Okay class, it is a very good reaction if you want a different kind of alcohol, which is which you get from acidification or by using acid. As by acidification, it can lead to rearrangement in the alkene, but in B2H6 there is no chance of rearrangement occurring. As in this case of alkene, if we firstly do it by acidification, H plus will be adding to the carbon which is more electron rich, right? Or in other word, I can say, which will form an intermediate or a carbocation which is more stable. As here you can see, this is a 2 degree carbocation is formed. If the H is going here, this will be a 1 degree carbocation which will be forming, which is less stable than a 2 degree. That's why this intermediate has been formed, right class? So this is again a Markownikoff kind of a addition that is occurring, right? This CH3 will be attacking at this positive charge. This kind of rearrangement can happen in by using hydrolysis by acid, not in the case of diborane, as I am telling you. This CH3 will be going here, and a tertiary carbocation will be formed, which is more stable than 2 degree. That's why this rearrangement is occurring here. With hydrolysis with water, this kind of alcohol is formed. But in case of diborane, as I told you, no rearrangement will be taking place. Hence, with B2H6, this kind of alkyl borane will be formed, which will be treated with or oxidized with H2O2 and base in base and forming alcohol, which is contrary to the alcohol which we have got. This is that alcohol which you can write it as theoretical also. Hence, there is no rearrangement that has occurred. But if you see the molecule, it is addition is antimarkownikoff in nature. Right? B2H6 add in Markownikoff sense, but after you get alcohol, if you compare the starting and the alcohol, this reaction is showing an anti-Markownikoff fashion. Keep in mind, the addition is Markownikoff in nature, but the fashion it is showing is anti-Markownikoff with the end product. As I told you, the BH2 and H add from the same side. That's why this reaction is called syn-addition. The reaction follows syn-addition. If the reaction is following syn-addition, that means the H and the BH2 are adding from the same side. That means the OH will be in the same stereochemistry as the H on the other carbon, right? If I take this as a question, right, and add BH3 to it. As you know, the CH3 present here will be in one direction, right, and HBH2 will be attacking from the rear part. If I am considering CH2 to be far from me, that means a dash kind of a thing I am considering with CH3. That means H and BH2 will be adding from the above. If it is down, then they are adding from above. That means the stereochemistry of OH and CH3 will be opposite to each other. Right, class? In this case also, firstly, H and BH2 will be adding. You can add H or BH2 anyway because this molecule is exactly symmetrical. And then that BH2 will be oxidized to OH and alcohol will be formed. This reaction shows syn-addition. Markownikoff addition rule is proceeded because the borone is more electropositive than hydrogen, right? But the product will show anti-Markownikoff fashion, as I told you. Now I will be dealing with the percentage yield of both the products which can be formed. As like in this molecule, there is a substitution here also, but this substitution is bulky. That means OH coming here will be showing Markownikoff rule and OH coming here will be showing anti-Markownikoff fashion. And as I told you, anti-Markownikoff fashion is more pronounced in the case of diborane. That's why this product which is formed is in 57%. A higher percentage is given to this product, a higher percentage yield is of this product than this, because attack is taking place in anti-Markownikoff fashion. Due to the bulkiness of both the groups, there is a mixture product that you will be getting, not a single product. Okay, class? Here is another example of the same thing. Here the substituent is CCH3 whole thrice. That's a very bulky group. And here only CH3. That means this group will be getting OH, which will be having more yield. As you can see here, it is having 58% yield, whereas this is having only 42% yield. But both are substituted. This is more bulkier. That's why the yield is less. Now, let's do the other reaction given by diborane, such as isomerization. Isomerization occurs in diborane at moderate temperature. Moderate temperature means 150 and above high temperature, right? So, if this is my alkene and it is attacking, right, it is attacked by borane. Okay, it is attacked by borane. Here it is propyl, here it is ethyl, right? So this is less bulky, this is more bulky. That's why this will be getting attached by borane, as shown to you here. I have made it three, I have attacked it thrice because B has three hydride into itself, three hydrogens which can attack the double bond. Hence, this kind of moiety will be formed. When this is formed, it will show isomerization at high temperature. Means instead of at getting attached here, it will change its attachment to here, and the hydrogen from here will come to this CH, and this kind of isomerization will be formed. This kind of organoborane will be formed, which will hydrolyze to give a N alkyl alcohol. That means a linear chain alcohol will be formed instead of a branch chain, which should be formed here at lower temperature. So at high temperature, isomerization will be seen. Same kind of example I have taken in another molecule. If this is my molecule, boron will be getting itself attached to this place, this double bond, right? So after this is formed due to high temperature, or I will say a higher temperature than the required one, isomerization will take place, and the proton from here will come here, and the boron will get itself attached here, which on hydrolysis will form this kind of alcohol instead of OH in the ring. It is outside the ring. Diborane can also form ketones on the process. As you know, diborane can form alcohols which can be oxidized with any oxidizing agent. You know, n number of oxidizing agents which can be oxidized to ketones. As in this case, I have used Jones reagent to oxidize it to ketone. So diboranes can help in ketone formation also. The next kind of reaction I am showing you is coupling reaction. Firstly, from here, diborane will be reacting with a double bond, and this kind of moiety will be formed. Instead of its oxidation to alcohol, what I have added AgNO3 in the presence of KOH, which will make it couple. That means CH2 will be coupling to CH2. Two of these molecules will be coupling to form a bigger alkane instead of an alcohol, because I have used a coupling reagent here. Now let's do the next type of reaction, that is carbonylation. That means a carbon is being introduced in the borane, right? Till this step, you know how to reach. By an alkene, we can form this kind of a moiety, right? Organoborane can be formed. Now, the carbonyl, that is CO, will be added to it, and then its oxidation will be done to form a carbonylation product, right? So, let's do the mechanism. The carbon here will be attacking, will be taking electrons from this bond and will be attacking the boron, right? In turn, boron will be getting a negative charge, and carbon will be getting a positive charge because it has only three bonds here, right? Now, due to this positive charge, this R group will migrate here. This is the first migration that is going to occur. And afterwards, what will happen? As boron is here, electron deficient, the oxygen electron will attack here, and the boron will be now having a negative charge, where the carbon will be having a positive charge, because the carbon is now having only three bonds attached. So in the respect, second migration will take place, because boron is having four bonds having negative charge, hence can give its alkyl group, which will be transferred to carbon, and this kind of moiety will be formed, right, class? Now it is the turn of the third migration, which will be happening by two reaction in one concerted step. This CO bond will be cleaved and B double bond O will be formed. In turn, the alkyl group attached to boron will be moved towards C. So O double bond B single bond CR3 will be formed, which is oxidized to form an alcohol, and a boric acid will be formed here as a byproduct. And alcohol, as you can see, is formed, which is having one carbon more and having three R groups. Whereas, if we don't do carbonization, we get only ROH, not this kind of a product. Right, class? Let's do the reactions with acetylene now. In acetylene, when a I have taken an organoborane here. If a BH bond is added, this kind of vinylic substance, vinylic species is formed, which is hydrolyzed to get a enol form. As you know, enol form is not that stable. It get itself converted to a stabler form, that is a ketone. Hence, a ketone can be formed with the help of borane in reaction with acetylene or any of the alkyne. Better you will say alkyne. Right, here is a case of another alkyne with boron I have treated it, and this kind of vinyl species is formed in C2, which is hydrolyzed to give this alcohol as a product. Right, class? Now, let's start with organoboranes. Organoboranes are prepared by the reaction of boranes with or diborane with various alkenes. As in the case, this alkene is used is and it is forming diisoamyl borane. If this alkene is used, it is forming hexyl borane. There is a third kind of hindered borane also known as 9-BBN, 9-borospicyclo-3-3-1 non-nonane, right? These are hindered in nature. Due to their bulkiness, they are less reactive, hence more selective. They will be giving more yield than what borane or diborane is giving. As you can see in this case, if I am taking this kind of an alkene and treating it with diborane, 94% of the product is formed. But if I am treating this alkene with a hindered borane, a bulky borane, 99% of yield can be achieved of the product, right? Now let's see the second example. If I am taking this as my alkene and reacting it with borane, I am getting only 57% of this product, right? But if I am taking diisoamyl borane, then 95% of this product will be formed as the yield. So, as I told you, hindered borane gives you more yield of the desired product, right? Due to their bulkiness, they are more selective in nature. Now, this is a small assignment which I am giving to you for completion. Please do this assignment as a homework, which will make sure that you understood all the concept clearly. Okay, class? These are the answer to the last assignment given to you in the last lecture. This is a reagent that is amide, right? You can figure it out. It is amide. Dibal on low temperature with amide give you a aldehyde, as I have made here. Right, class? In the next case, there is a hindered lithium aluminium hydride derivative, that is tertiary butoxide, is used instead of hydride, which make it hindered. That means it is more selective, it stops the reaction in between, and low temperature is also used. Both the conditions will favor the reaction to be that the acid chloride will be converting to aldehyde only. In this case, as you know, NaBH4 will be reducing carbonyl group, not the acid group. The carbonyl group will be reducing to alcohol, and due to the close vicinity of the alcohol and the acid, there will be a dehydration by heating, and this kind of lactone will be formed as a product. In the last case, the first reaction is with RnH2. As you know, aldehydes react with RnH2 and form shift base, something like this. Right? A substituted imine will be formed, right? After the formation of this with NaBH3CN, this double bond will be reduced to an amine. So, imine will be reduced to an amine as the product of this reaction. Thanks for watching, guys. Please stay continued, stay connected for my next video. Take care.